This gentleman here.
Recording?
Yeah, I'm recording right now. It's happening. It's going into the memory chip. It's John Fitch. We're in Lime Rock. We got brass era of Bentleys and Rolls chugging by with huge cylinders.
Yeah.
We're going to have a moment with John Fitch. Discuss the Fitch Phoenix, the movable barrier, the Lime Rock racetrack that you designed, built, managed. Back in, when was this? This racetrack was?
57.
57. And what was this racetrack?
57. And when I came here in 55, this whole area here was a potato field.
No way.
And a stream that now is beside this half mile straight wandered all over the infield. You couldn't walk through there.
A little swampy, creepy and swampy.
And we dug a ditch and redirected the stream and made a street. And drained the infield so that we could have a
race. Have a race. Had all permits in place with the state.
Do it today.
We don't need no speaking permits. Well, John Fitch.
That's how our liberties have been infringed.
John Fitch in 1966 made the Fitch Phoenix, which is the prototype for the Corvette Stingray of 1968. It's debatable whether or not royalties were paid for those fender bumps to house the two spare tires.
Oh, that's a long story and a sad story for me, because this, you can imagine what I put into this effort to build a car.
It's a shortened chassis?
It's a Porsche prototype, and we were committed to make 500 of them that we planned, and the car was shown in California, in Miami, in New York, and Boston. And quite a few orders were taken, but we couldn't fill them because the government didn't issue the standards that applied. And it was 2 years before they issued them. And of course, people won't wait 2 years.
The interest dries up and the federal standards change.
Kill the whole thing.
Unbelievable. So this is a shortened, it's a shortened chassis?
Yeah. Well, it's 35 inches.
Same as the forward control truck, 95 inches.
Yeah.
Two-seater.
Yep.
144 carburetor engine.
It has 170 horse.
170.
By adjusting many things.
Yeah.
But without changing the pistons or the valves or anything that would prevent it from being serviced by a Chevrolet or a dealership.
Right, right. Well,
this was at a time when imported sports cars of this general category sat in a shop waiting for parts to come from Ferrari or Maserati in Italy. Whereas this is a car you could use every day. And it was not a race car, it was a road car. And there's a vast difference between the two. This is a good road car.
Now, who built this fiberglass body? This is obviously a one-off fiberglass body.
A 1 millimeter steel body.
Oh, it's a steel body?
Yeah, made in Turin, Italy, by Intermeccanica. Which was a car firm that made limited production cars.
And I presumed all along it was a fiberglass or gel coat. It's a steel body.
Yeah.
Made by
Intermechanica.
Yeah. Hand hammered on an English wheel. And
yes.
Oh my, what a beautiful. It makes it all the more interesting. Experimental test vehicle. Corvair at its finest.
Corby Whitmore was a dear friend and a brilliant illustrator, artist.
And that's Corey Whitmore?
His name was Coburn Whitmore.
Yes. Coburn Whitmore.
Yeah, and his nickname was Kobe. And we worked out this design, not only this car, but for the so-called Fitch Whitmore Jaguar, which I built
mm-hmm.
in 1951, and it was sold last month for $403,000.
That's the cycle fender Jaguar XK120.
That's right.
That's right. I know the vehicle. Cycle fender, original. It still retains original engine.
Finally, yes. It had Buicks and Cadillacs.
Throughout the 50s, in its race, but and never wrecked in its entire racing career.
Never wrecked. Incredible.
Could we see the engine? How do you access the engine?
Oh, well, it's easy.
Please, and it's got the sail panels just like a 68
right
Corvette.
And then you lift this up, and there's the engine.
Perfect access. Corvair 140, the air panels.
It's a 140 with race of 170.
And this
and
is
it has the Fitch fuel catalyst in it, which is pure magic.
State
pure
of Connecticut,
magic.
CT2800.
It does incredible things to fuel economy, reduction of emissions,
mm-hmm.
not unusual 50% reduction of emissions, not unusual 50%.
Bruce wants to say hi.
Why would anybody say hi?
A one-off interview, an exclusive interview with John Fitch, discussing his 1966 Fitch Phoenix. Steel-bodied, made by Intermechanica in Turin, Italy. John Fitch, we're in Lime Rock Racetrack in the Berkshires. In Lime Rock, at the design, engineered, design, racetrack, first trip in Lime Rock, Connecticut. John Fitch, we're here.